take one class which I used to take about auscultation of the respiratory system. As you have just heard, when I said auscultation, it means that I will tell you something regarding auscultation of respiratory system. Are you clear about the topic? Please raise your hands who has not auscultated the chest till this time. Raise your hands who has not auscultated. So I believe everybody has put stethoscope over the chest, right? ऐसा कोई नहीं है जिसने मतलब अभी तक auscultation ना किया हो. So it's a very common, what I'm trying to say, that it's a very common thing. And although I came at 9 o'clock, but I don't know much of the nitty-gritty of this place. As you know, the auscultation of the respiratory system, when you examine under four heads. I think everybody must be knowing this. Inspection, palpation, percussion, and auscultation. Clear? Please stop me if you are not clear at any stage. Because these lectures are very primitive and everybody should understand everything. So, after a good history, suppose you are seeing a respiratory patient, what is the job of a clinician? That after a good history, you should be able to know the at least differential diagnosis. That is the job of a history. History is not that you have just written in your case sheet and forget it. Believe me, if I see patient even today, and if I talk to the patient for 5 minutes, not for half an hour like you, now I am very clear in my mind in 95% to 98% situation that I am going to see this diagnosis. And that is actually proven. And why it is with me? Because between you and me, you know what is the difference? How many years? Huh? Kitne? 40 saal. Kis batch ke ho tum log? 14. Anyhow, your guess is very right. I belong to 70 batch. Jaise aap yahan pad rahe ho, मैं भी 70 में केजीएमसी में ऐसे ही पढ़ने आया था. तो आपसे लगभग मैं 44-45 साल सीनियर हूँ और उतने साल का एक्सपीरियंस भी है. एक्सपीरियंस का क्या मतलब होता है? एक्सपीरियंस मींस दैट योर एक्सपीरियंस इज अ क्लिनिकल एक्सपीरियंस. आई हैव टॉक्ड टू द पेशेंट, आई हैव एग्जामिन्ड द पेशेंट, आई हैव मेड द डायग्नोसिस, आई हैव ट्रीटेड देम. Then I also have known what has happened to them. That's the clinical experience. So that is why I said, if I'll take history today, just for 5 minutes to any patient coming to me, any respiratory patient coming to me, I will think about differential diagnosis at least. Number one, 98% cases, that is going to be proven after physical examination and after investigations. So if you want to reach at this stage, probably you have to work very hard. Message is very clear. So I was talking about auscultation. So under four headings, auscultation is the last thing to do. So after a history, you do physical examination. And in physical examination, you also know that you do general examination first, and then you go to the systemic examination. After this, and systemic examination, system involved is examined first. Are you aware of this? Suppose somebody had cough, expectoration, breathlessness. So I came to know that it is a respiratory system. So respiratory system should be examined first. Why it is examined first? Because you have to spend more time on main system. And then the third component of physical examination is rest of the other systems. Then your history and physical examination is complete. Clear? So, I am talking about physical examination of respiratory system, not all, only auscultation. That's the introduction of my topic. Now, when you ask, there are two, three things which you are very, which should be very aware. What should be the, how the patient should take breathing when you auscultate? First thing, you should have a good stethoscope. अगर आपके वो 50-100 रुपए वाला स्टेथोस्कोप है उसे आपके पास फेंक दीजिए आफ्टर दिस लेक्चर बिकॉज व्हाई आई एम सेइंग दिस ऑस्कल्टेशन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट वेदर इट इज रेस्पिरेटरी वेदर इट इज एनी सिस्टम व्हाट एवर स्टेथोस्कोप यू हैव टुडे इफ इट इज अ गुड ब्रांड इट विल परसिस्ट थ्रू आउट योर लाइफ विद यू व्हाट एवर इज दिस आई हैव A very good stethoscope that is still with me because my ears becomes accustomed with that stethoscope. So first requisite of a good auscultation, maybe of any system, have a good stethoscope from very beginning and try to stick with that. वो तभी कर पाओगे जब अच्छा stethoscope रखोगे. That's clear. Second prerequisite for auscultation. That you, when you auscultate the chest, your chest piece of the stethoscope should be in a close contact with the chest wall. So all the technical issues, आपका आला घूम गया, एक डॉक्टर साहब आए और बोले साहब मुझे कुछ सुनाई नहीं पड़ रहा, और हमने देखा कि उनका आला ही घूम गया है, तो कहाँ से सुनाई पड़ेगा? So you should be technically sound. Yes, your stethoscope is working. That's another issue. Patients should breathe with open mouth. With open mouth. Fairly deeply. ऐसा नहीं आपने कहा सांस भरो क्या सुनाई पड़ेगा कुछ सुनाई पड़ेगा So when you go सांस भरो तब आपको कुछ उसमें सुनाई पड़ेगा सो द पेशेंट शुड ब्रीद विद माउथ ओपन फेयरली डीपली रेगुलरली ऐसा नहीं ऐसा ऐसा सांस लेते तो उसमें क्या उसमें जो भी सुनाई पड़ेगा उल्टा होगा तुम्हारा देन थर्ड वर्ड इज नॉट नॉइजली अब मरीज कई ऐसा सांस लेते हैं क्या भाई सांस तो ऐसा करना शुरू कर देते हैं So not that. Then your all the findings will be something which you are not able to interpret. So these are the three prerequisites for a good auscultation of respiratory system. Samajh mein aaya, nahi aaya? Then the third question is asked in prerequisite, what should be the position when you auscultate? Kya hona chahiye? Ideally we say either the patient is sitting or patient is lying down. यही दो पोजीशन होंगे जिसमें आजकल टेस्ट करोगे एंड इफ पेशेंट इज वेरी सिक देन यू रोल इट एक बार आजकल टेस्ट करो फिर कहो दूसरी तरफ भाई उधर करवट ले लो दूसरी तरफ आजकल टेस्ट कर लो सो व्हाट आई मीन दीज थिंग्स आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दीज आर द प्री रिक्विजिट फॉर ऑस्कल्टेशन देन यू विद आफ्टर दीज प्री रिक्विजिट्स यू स्टार्ट ऑस्कल्टेटिंग And when you auscultate the respiratory system, you have got three aims in your mind. First is, what is breath sounds like? Clear? The second aim is the, what is the vocal resonance? And third aim is, any added sounds? I hope the time you are sitting here, you are aware about these things. This is just a revision. आप ये वर्ड समझ पा रहे हैं ना? Added sound, vocal resonance. So, always when I auscultate any part of the chest, I have got three aims in my mind. In that particular area, what is the breath sounds? Is there any added sound? And then what is vocal resonance? Mind it, vocal resonance is same as occult fremitus. Another name of occult fremitus is tactile fremitus, because in occult fremitus you just take the sense of touch. हाथ पैसे रख के मरीज से कहते हैं एक दो तीन या 99 वट एवर यू बोलो और आप कंपेयर करते हो चारों तरफ. सेम थिंग इज डन विद स्टेथोस्कोप, देन इट बिकम्स ओकल रेजोनेंस, बट बोथ आर द सेम. ऐसा नहीं हो सकता है कि आप कहें कि ओकल फ्रिमेटस इज डिक्रीज एंड ओकल रेजोनेंस इज इंक्रीज. इट मीन्स सम प्रॉब्लम समवेयर इन यू, because both the things are the same, it has kept at two places, just to test you. Kya kar rahe ho aap log? So 3 aim, let me talk about the first aim. What is breath sounds like? Now you know, normally there are two types of breath sounds. One is bronchial breathing, the other first is vesicular breathing, and second is bronchial. These are two basic type of breathing. When you auscultate through your normal lung, this is the vesicular breathing. When you auscultate, need not to go to the patient even, when you auscultate, put your stethoscope over the trachea, whatever breathing you listen is the bronchial breathing. So, if you want to recognize vesicular and bronchial breathing, you may not require to go to the patient. In your own body, you can do it. Normally, here is a vesicular breathing, and normally, here is a bronchial breathing. But let me tell to you that what are the basic differences between vesicular breathing and bronchial breathing, and what are their variations. Then you will be able to understand that what are the types of breathing which are you are going to listen. And then at this stage, you should also be able to interpret them. So, you know, शायद चल नहीं रहा बता रहे हैं. ये यहाँ दिख रहा है तुम लोगों को? This board is visible. So, if I write this as a vesicular breathing, and if I write here as a bronchial breathing, so what are the main differences between these two types of breathing? When we talk of a differences, we talk in terms of duration of sound. When we say duration, you know that if this is inspiration occurring and this is expiration occurring, and what you listen as far as duration in vesicular breathing is concerned, you listen whole of the inspiratory phase and then 1/3 of expiratory phase. That's why you always say in vesicular breathing, the duration ratio between expiratory and inspiratory sound is 1:3. ऐसा कुछ पढ़ाया गया आप लोगों को? नहीं है. एंड एज फार एज ड्यूरेशन ऑफ ब्रांकियल ब्रीदिंग इज कंसर्न, इफ आई ड्रॉ द सेम लाइन, व्हाट यू लिसन इन ब्रांकियल ब्रीदिंग इज होल ऑफ द इंस्पिरेटरी फेज एक्सेप्ट एट द एंड एंड देन होल ऑफ द एक्सपिरेटरी फेज. सो रेशियो बिटवीन दिस एंड दिस इज 1:1. So it is very clear, when you listen a vesicular breathing, whole of the inspiratory phase and only initial part of the expiratory phase is heard, and in bronchial breathing both the phases are heard equally. So that is the first difference. What is the second difference? Second difference is the character of sound. If you ask me, sir, how you recognize bronchial or vesicular breathing, I'll say I recognize by character of sound. Although I take these steps also into consideration, character of sound, it is rustling in character, and this is hollow or aspirate in character. Now, I cannot explain you what these characters are, but I just said to you, if you want to listen what is rustling in character, put your stethoscope over your chest if you are normal. That is rustling. Put your stethoscope over trachea, that is hollow or aspirate. That's how these breathings are mainly recognized by the character of the sound. What is the third difference? Third difference is the intensity of sound. Intensity of sound, in case of vesicular breathing, if I put inspiratory sound and expiratory sound, in case of vesicular breathing, it is 2 plus and it is 1 plus. So, predominant is inspiratory phase, as far as intensity of sound is concerned. But if I put same way in bronchial breathing, inspiratory sound is as intense, it is 2 plus, as vesicular breathing, and expiratory sound I'll put as 3 plus. So here both the phases are intense, but it is the expiratory phase which is predominant. Yehi sunai padta jab sunte ho bronchial or vesicular breathing. And the fourth difference, as you see this diagram, is very clear about the gap, which you talk of always. There is no gap in vesicular breathing and there is a gap here in bronchial breathing. So these are the four basic differences between these two types of breathing. But I have already given you a hint. If you want to practice, listen here, that's the bronchial breathing. Listen here, that's the vesicular breathing. Now, when you have heard these two types of basic breathing, there are certain variation of both types of breathing. Like many, very commonly what you say is, if you concentrate here, if this phase, expiratory phase is prolonged, then it is known as vesicular breathing with prolonged expiration. And it is also known as harsh vesicular breathing. So that's the one variation. And it's a very common variation. If you develop experience, if I will listen a harsh vesicular breathing, it indicates that there is a major airway obstruction. So this is a one variation, is a harsh vesicular or vesicular breathing with prolonged. The another variation in your case presentation, you must have talked about the intensity of the sound, and in intensity of the sound, breath sound may be diminished or may be absent. Many times you say in your presentation, breath sound is diminished. Diminished absence means air is not going in that particular lung because of any reason. That's why you get so harsh vesicular breathing, diminished vesicular breathing, absent vesicular breathing, and then so these are the common variation of vesicular breathing. What are the variation of bronchial breathing? There are three types of bronchial breathing. I'll just spell them: cavernous, tubular, and amphoric. अब हाथ उठाओ, अब पहला हाथ ये उठाओ, कितने लोगों ने vesicular breathing सुनी है? Common sense से सबके हाथ उठने चाहिए. अगर आजकल तुमने सबने कहा था कि हमने आजकल टेस्ट किया है, तो अब सबके हाथ यहाँ उठने चाहिए कायदे से. ये हाथ बहुत कम उठे. कितने लोगों ने bronchial breathing सुनी है? वेरी फ्यू. इसको मतलब मरीज नहीं देखते हो, बड़ा क्लियर है, जाते हो वार्ड में घूम के चले आते हो, हैं? दैट इम्प्लाइज कितने लोगों ने ये ब्रीदिंग सुनी है? कैवर्नस, ट्यूबुलर, एम्फोरिक, नाम सुना है? नाम सुना ना. सो व्हाट इज कैवर्नस? कैवर्नस इज लो पिच्ड टाइप ऑफ ए ब्रांकियल ब्रीदिंग एंड इट इज प्रेजेंट इन कैविटी. When if I hear a cavernous type of a bronchial breathing, I am definitely going to get a cavity in the chest x-ray, RCT. But not every cavity in the chest x-ray will produce cavernous breathing. Vice versa is not true. Because for a cavity, you need certain prerequisite, then it will produce a cavernous type of a bronchial breathing. Next, breathing is tubular, means high pitch, means consolidation. नाम सुना ही होगा. सो अगर हाई पिच ब्रीदिंग हमको सुनाई पड़ रही है ब्रांकियल, तो हम कहेंगे यहां पर कंसोलिडेशन होगा. बट रिवर्स वाइस वर्सा इज अगेन नॉट ट्रू. नॉट एवरी कंसोलिडेशन विल क्रिएट अ हाई पिच ब्रांकियल ब्रीदिंग. एंड थर्ड इज एम्फोरिक. किसी ने सुना एम्फोरिक ब्रीदिंग? रेज योर हैंड अगर किसी ने सुना है. तो पूरे क्लास में किसी ने नहीं सुना. ये मैडम आप लोगों का फेलियर है. आप तो अब तो 1.5 साल हो गया ना पल्मोनरी मेडिसिन में. तो ये बच्चे आते हैं, इनको सुनवाइए हैं सब तरह की ब्रीदिंग. तब तो आपके रेजिडेंसी होने का फायदा है. हमको भी सुनवाया था ऐसे रेजिडेंट ने हमारे जमाने के पहली बार. एम्फोरिक ब्रीदिंग इज बिकॉज वंस यू लिसन एम्फोरिक ब्रीदिंग यू विल नेवर फॉरगेट इन योर लाइफ टाइम. दैट इज व्हाई आई एम सेइंग दिस वर्ड्स. एम्फोरिक ब्रीदिंग इज बेसिकली लो पिच्ड टाइप ऑफ ब्रांकियल ब्रीदिंग associated with high pitched overtones. And this breathing, if you whistle in a bottle, similar type of sound is produced in amphoric breathing. And that whistling sound what you listen is probably the high pitched overtones, not the basic that is low pitched. So, and if you listen amphoric breathing, it communicates two things to you. You know, clinical medicine is a science, is a math. Like, if I listen amphoric breathing, causes are only two. One is large cavity. As you see in the medium-sized cavity, you find a cavernous breathing. But the cavity is very large and communicating with the bronchus, it will be amphoric breathing. And second is pneumothorax. Do you know pneumothorax? Air in the pleura. Pneumothorax are hydropneumothorax, air and fluid both, with patent bronchopleural fistula. And that will produce amphoric breathing. So it's so clear, if I listen amphoric breathing today, my only diagnosis is two, whether it is a large cavity, whether it is a pneumo or hydro with patent bronchopleural fistula. So these are the variation of the bronchial breathing. There is a yet another variation which we listen even today, day-to-day clinical practice. Although, if you read, pata nahi kaun si kitab padhte ho clinical medicine ki, kya padhte ho aajkal? Hain? Kya? Hutchinson, na? तो हचिंसन ने आजकल ये सब काफी कम कर दिया है. कम करने का उसका वैलिड रीजन है. हचिंसन इज फ्रॉम अदर कंट्रीज, डेवलप्ड कंट्री, वहां ये कुछ नहीं सुनाई पड़ता. बट इफ यू रीड हचिंसन ऑफ 60s, 70s, 80s, यू विल फाइंड ऑल ब्रीदिंग. बट नाउ दे डोंट लिसन, सो दे हैव रिमूव दैट. इट मीन्स दैट यू डू नॉट लिसन. वी लिसन हियर, दैट्स व्हाई वी टीच आल्सो. So, ये ब्रीदिंग सब सुनाई पड़ती. तीसरी ब्रीदिंग क्या मैं कहने जा रहा हूं, वो इन दोनों के बीच में. इट इज इन बिटवीन वेसिकुलर एंड ब्रांकियल एंड दिस इज नोन एज ब्रांको वेसिकुलर ब्रीदिंग. वेरी फ्यू पीपुल से अबाउट दिस, बट दिस इज अ रियलिटी. इवन यू लिसन नाउअडेज, इवन टुडे, व्हाट इज ब्रांको वेसिकुलर ब्रीदिंग? You know, when to declare it as a bronchial breathing, both the phases should be hollow, inspiratory as well as expiratory. But in many times you listen that only one phase is hollow. So one phase is like vesicular, means rustling, and one phase is like bronchial, means hollow. Then we call such type of breathing is bronchovesicular breathing. You will not find everything in one book. What I am teaching you, this is after 50 books. right? And ranging from 50 years. And but the utility of this is that this is even listened, we listen today. And I can only listen if I know the theory. If I know that what I'm able to listen. हम सुनेंगे वही जो हमारा दिमाग जानता है. अगर दिमाग जैसे नहीं जानता, हमारे पीजी लोगों का भी दिमाग नहीं जानता तो नहीं सुनते हैं लोग. हमारा दिमाग जानता है तो हम सुनते हैं, हमको सुनाई पड़ता है. सो ब्रांकोवेसिकुलर ब्रीदिंग. नाउ नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन कम्स इन माइंड, व्हाट इज द सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ ए ब्रांकोवेसिकुलर ब्रीदिंग. ब्रांकोवेसिकुलर ब्रीदिंग, द फर्स्ट सिग्निफिकेंस इज इट कैन बी नॉर्मली प्रेजेंट लाइक ए वेसिकुलर ब्रीदिंग वेर द लार्ज ब्रांकस is in close contact with the chest wall. And those areas are two. One is right infraclavicular area, where right main bronchus is quite close approximation with the chest wall. So especially in a thin-chested individual, you may listen a bronchovascular breathing. Sometimes you may listen even a bronchial breathing in a normal person. So, and second area is where root of the lung lies. Root of the lung lies hilum. Where hilum lies is just behind the spine of the scapula. In the center, you may get a vesicular, bronchovesicular breathing, or even sometimes a bronchial breathing in a normal individual. So, first lesson is this, such type of breathing can be normally heard. If it is not normally heard, then its significance is like a bronchial breathing. That's why the new generation, our colleagues, our residents, even new generation faculty, when they don't appreciate these words, so bronchovascular breathing, they also classify into the bronchial breathing. But these two things you have to understand. So now you know that What are the various type of breathing which you are likely to listen, right? And if you know this, if you are, your mind is loaded with all this, then you may listen all this. Or mind nahi load hai, to nahi sunai padega. That was the first aim. What is the second aim? Let me talk first added sound. There are three types of added sound again. One is ronchi, is crepes, and third is pleural rub. I hope all of you must have heard all these added sounds. Suna ki nahi suna? Sar nahi hil rahe sabke. I'll not go into any very depth, but I'll just give you the practical issues. Ronchi means they are continuous type of sound. And when you listen ronchi, it indicates usually the narrowing of airways. Narrowing of the airways. Not complete obliteration. If the complete obliteration, you will listen no breath sounds, no added sound. But when it is a partially obstructed, like asthma, like COPD, are you aware of these two terms? So, ये दो disease जिसमें airway obstruction होता है, उसमें आपको ronchi सुनाई पड़ सकता है. Now, ronchi as a general sense means it is a generalized finding because these two diseases are generalized. Say, asthma and COPD, both are generalized disease, not a localized disease. So usually ronchi are heard generalized in all over the chest. And it's indicate to you as a clinician that there is an airway obstruction and patient will require treatment of airway obstruction. If suppose somebody is coughing and he is having harsh vesicular breathing, and with ronchi, his cough, you cannot suppress his cough by cough suppressant. But you will relieve his cough by giving expectorants and bronchodilator. That's the clinical message hidden with such type of findings. So I was telling you that ranchai really are generalized. But sometimes the ranchai can be localized also. Localized means it is heard in particular area. Now, how to react as a clinician, how to react with localized ranchai? What does it mean to you? Now, localized ranchai, if it is not persistent, means you put your stethoscope, you listen ranchai, and you ask the patient to cough, or after some time, it automatically disappears. The ranchai which is not persistent is not important. And it may be because of some mucus plugging, something temporarily there and it has got removed. So what is message? If the localized ranchai is temporary, is not persistent, is not important. As a clinician, we have just attached no importance. But if the localized ranchai is persistent, it has got importance. As a generalized ranchai indicates obstruction, so the localized ranchai also indicates the local obstruction. And local obstruction may be because of some mediastinal lymph node pressing over one of the bronchus, narrowing its lumen. Some growth inside the wall of the bronchus, narrowing the lumen, like endobronchial TB, like bronchogenic carcinoma, they all can produce in a situation where bronchi are narrowed to some extent, you may get. And sometimes if there is a foreign body inside, that can also produce a localized ranchai. I will give you one story, probably which you will be able to understand more. I saw one of my, let me say, teachers in 90s, I am talking, when I was in KGMC. One fine morning he came to me and said, "Rajendra, I have got breathlessness." So I asked him, "You never had breathlessness, I know you for last so many years." So, "Lekin yaar, aaj subah se humari saans phool rahi hai." So I just examined, took history, examined him, and I found only finding is the localized ranchai. His ranchai was there at one side and it was persistent. So I said, I thought those three, whether lymph node will not appear in one day, cancer will not appear in one day, what can appear in one day is a foreign body. So maine unse pucha, "Sir, koi cheez nikal to nahi gaya?" Bole, "Nahi, kuch nahi. Raat ko khana khaya, soya, subah utha to saans phool rahi." Sudden answer, breathless. So maine kaha, "Sir, aise to kuch samajh nahi hai, lekin ye localized, what I am trying to say you, localized ranchai, if it is persistent, it is not to be, usko investigate karna bahut zaruri hai." So I investigated him. Humne kaha, "Sir, ek x-ray kara ke dekhte hain." X-ray mein dekha, to ek daant type ka kuch x-ray mein mila. Phir unhone apna muh khola, sir ne kaha, "Yaar, mera to gold crown tha, wo to kahe, ye to hai nahi." To maine kaha, "Sab wo andar hai." So what I am trying to say, sometimes foreign body aspiration, you know that foreign body aspiration is usually heralded by violent cough, breath, but it's not like that. Many times we have seen that foreign body without knowing the patient. So that was a foreign body, it was removed and he got well. So what I am trying to say, these findings have implication. Ye sirf case sheet mein likhne ke liye nahi hai. If you understand, if you interpret these findings, you may become a better clinician. Wo doctor sahab aaj bhi mujhe yaad rakhte hain. Kehte hain, yaar, tumne khoob pehchana. Kaise pehchana? Humne sahab yahi padhate hain, yahi isi se pehchana. So that is ranchai. Now the second added sound is crepes. I will not go into any detail. Crepes is a very confusing. But what you should remember as an MBBS student, final year MBBS student, that there are two types of crepes. One is fine and second is coarse. Fine crepes is end inspiratory crepes. Crepes You know crabs are intermittent sound, you must have heard. And crabs which are present at the end of the inspiration, that is the fine crabs. Rest of the crabs you may say at a course, means course crabs may be in one phase, maybe in both the phase. So you have to recognize whether it is a fine crabs or it is a coarse crabs. What do you mean by, what is the significance? If I listen fine crabs today, how should I interpret? That is the question. Question, the answer is that disease somehow, early disease, it indicates early disease, one. And second, it indicates the site of disease also. Disease is present at the end of the bronchial system. Maybe alveoli, maybe interstitium. So you know the common causes of fine crabs are early tuberculosis, early pneumonia. Pneumonia shuru ho raha kahin pe, alveoli mein secretions aa gaye, that you will get as a fine crabs. Early ILDs, you will get a fine crabs. So interstitial disease, alveolar disease, occurring at the extreme end, and disease is early, you may get a fine crabs. Coarse crabs may be many reasons. Commonest cause of coarse crabs in India is, if I say, is COPD. And as you know, the COPD is generalized disease, so it will produce a generalized all over. The another cause for coarse crabs is bronchiectasis. Have you heard bronchiectasis? Bronchiectasis is a localized disease. So what you listen as a coarse crabs is a localized. And since bronchiectasis is common at the bases, lower lobes, so what you find at one of the lower lobes, say infrascapular area, you may listen a coarse type of, coarse, bubbly, once you hear a coarse crabs of bronchiectasis, you will never forget in your life. लेकिन सवाल ये, आप लोग सुनते कहाँ हो? सबसे बड़ी प्रॉब्लम ये है. अब यही है, जब वार्ड में जाते हो तो पकड़ो इन लोगों को और पकड़ के सुनो रेजिडेंट लोगों को, यही काम होता है. सो कोर्स क्रैप्स में, सोर्स ऑफ कोर्स क्रैप्स में भी एज आई सेड सीओपीडी, ब्रांकियेक्टेसिस, इफ देयर इज अ कैविटी देयर लॉट ऑफ सिक्रेशन, देयर माइट बी कोर्स क्रैप्स, रिजॉल्विंग न्यूमोनिया, न्यूमोनिया अर्ली स्टेज, फाइन क्रैप्स. Pneumonia at resolving stage, lot of secretion, so it will be fine crabs. It will be coarse crabs. So that is how you interpret coarse crepitation. Then third added sound is pleural rub. Now as a clinician, अभी मैंने कल मरीज देखा, pleural effusion का मरीज था, वो मरीज ठीक हो रहा है. फिर आ गया साहब पेन हो रहा, फिर वहीं जहाँ पहले पेन हुआ था फिर पेन हो रहा. सो प्लूरल रब मीन्स वेन इन्फ्लेम्ड प्लूरा रब अगेंस्ट ईच अदर, दे प्रोड्यूस प्लूरल रब एंड इट इज यूजली अकॉम्पनीड बाई पेन, प्लूरल टाइप ऑफ अ पेन. सो प्लूरल रब इज अगेन प्रेजेंट इन बोथ द फेजेस. इट इज अ रबिंग टाइप ऑफ साउंड, इट इज नॉट इंटरप्टेड, नॉट कॉन्टिन्यूस. It is a rubbing type of sound and it clearly indicates that there is a pleural inflammation. And I have given you the message, when disease starts, jab pleura inflame hua to dono ragadne lage aur dono ke beech mein jab fluid aa gaya to dono alag ho gaye, pain khatam ho jayega. Fluid aana, it indicates ki pain, mareez bada khush ho gaya, पेन खत्म हो गया. लेकिन पेन खत्म होता है तो उसको ब्रेथलेसनेस शुरू हो जाता है, क्योंकि वो पानी भरना शुरू हो जाता है. और जब फिर पानी सूखना शुरू हो जाता है, मेनी टाइम्स दे रब अगेंस्ट ईच अदर अगेन, व्हेन फ्लूइड हैज अब्सॉर्ब्ड दे आर रबिंग अगेंस्ट ईच अदर, पेन में रीअपीयर. सो इफ यू आर अ गुड क्लिनिशियन, यू मे एक्सप्लेन टू योर पेशेंट एंड पेशेंट विल नॉट run away from you. What is the problem with ERA? What I have observed in last 1 and 2 years, यहाँ मरीज ठहरता ही नहीं. तो मरीज ठहरने के लिए बड़े अच्छे डॉक्टर चाहिए, बड़ा अच्छा फॉलोअप चाहिए, तब तो मरीज रुकेगा. और देख रहा डॉक्टर भी लापरवाह, कुछ सुन ही नहीं रहा, आधी बात समझ ही नहीं रहा, तो क्यों आएगा आपके पास? वो भाग करके कहीं और चला जाता है. सो फॉलोअप के लिए, बुलाने के लिए मरीज को, यू हैव टू हैव अ गुड क्लिनिकल हैबिट्स. अब ये दो हो गए सब, तीसरा क्या रह गया? फाइनली 2-3 मिनट्स इज द vocal resonance. Now, vocal resonance means, as I have just told you, you ask the patient to say 1, 2, 3 or 99 and you listen with your stethoscope over all the areas and compare it from one side to other side. That is how you elicit vocal resonance. Vocal resonance can be absent, can be increased. So when it is diminished or absent, it goes with the absent or diminished vesicular breath sound. What are the causes of those? Same will causes of the diminished vesicular vocal resonance. Increased vocal resonance, there are three types of increase. One term is known as a bronchophony. Pata nahi naam suna nahi suna, mujhe nahi pata. Second is egophony. Bronchophony means vocal resonance is increased to the extent that somebody is speaking at the level of your chest piece. And bronchophony ka ek further increase or what is known as whispering pectoralicky. Suna na? Whispering pectoralicky means if you in vocal resonance, normally you ask the patient to say 1, 2, 3. But if you find vocal resonance is increased, you ask your patient to whisper 1, 2, 3. जैसे पहले आप कहते हैं भाई बोलो भैया 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3 बोलो. फिर आप देखते हैं बढ़ा हुआ है ये एक तरफ में, तो वहां आप उससे ask him to whisper 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And these whispered words, it is clearly audible into your ears as somebody is directly whispering into your ears. This is known as, so this is extreme rise of the vocal resonance, and it is present with bronchial breathing wherever there is, or even with bronchovesicular breathing. So that's the whispering pectoralicky. What is egophony? Egophony is, this is again an increased vocal resonance, but to these sounds a nasal character is added. So that's the egophony. That's how you interpret the vocal resonance. Now if I have to complete auscultation, probably I have to tell you one more finding, which is a percussion, what is very complex finding. It can involve shaking of the patient and listening. वो क्या finding होती है chest में, जिसमें मतलब आप हिलाते हो मरीज को और फिर आले से सुनते भी हो. क्या कह रहे हैं भाई ये लोग? Have you heard succussion splash? Succussion splash. Succussion splash का मतलब क्या है? सुराही में पानी रख दो आधा भरा हुआ और उसको हिलाओ तो साउंड सुनाई पड़ता ना, दैट इज अ सक्कसन स्प्लैश. तो कभी कभी तो आप नेकेड आपने ऐसे आईस ईयर से सुन लो तो भी सुनाई पड़ सकता, लेकिन आले से बेहतर सुनाई. व्हाट यू डू, यू आस्क दैट इफ यू सस्पेक्ट हाइड्रोन्यूमोथोरेक्स. सक्कसन स्प्लैश इज अ पैथोजनोमिक फिजिकल साइन फॉर हाइड्रोन्यूमोथोरेक्स. So if I suspect hydropneumothorax by many more findings, then I ask patient, भाई मैं तुम्हें हिलाऊंगा. ऐसा ना हो कि बिना बताए उसे हिला दो, वो मार देगा लपड़. अरे उसे पेन ऐसे ही हो रहा है, आप उसे और तो हिला रहे हो, वो भाग जाएगा, कभी आएगा नहीं आपके पास. कहेगा ये डॉक्टर है बेवकूफ है, मैं दर्द बता रहा हूँ और ये मुझे हिलाया जा रहा. तो यू आस्क हिम, भैया मैं तुम्हें हिलाऊंगा. कल मैंने मरीज एक देखा, उसने कहा साहब जब मेरे पिछली बार हुआ था हाइड्रोन्यूमोथोरेक्स का केस था, बोले साहब मेरा मैं हिलता था तो मुझे भी सुनाई पड़ता था. तो दिस इज नॉट दैट दिस इज रिटन इन द बुक, दिस इज इफ यू डू अ हाइड्रोन्यूमोथोरेक्स, सो दैट कंप्लीट्स द ऑस्कल्टेशन. व्हाट इज अ टेक होम मैसेज? टेक होम मैसेज इज इफ यू वॉन्ट टू बिकम अ गुड क्लिनिशियन, विच मैनी ऑफ यू ड्रीम टू बिकम, whether you will become at that time will tell. Then probably each patient you are seeing, you must take history properly, you must do the examination including the auscultation, and you have just seen that many of the findings of auscultation may help in diagnosis. I mean, even may help in deciding the treatment. Thank you very much.